your five favorite relatives, the mothers.
Featuring Napoleon Murphy Brock on tenor sax and lead vocals. Andre Lewis on keyboards. Little skinny Terry Ted Bozio on drums. Roy Estrada on bass. And Davey, son of Managua, on mixing console and opening announcement. We want to make sure that you all know who he is. Meanwhile, in the dark, where all the fevers go, under the water, where the shark bubbles blow, in the morning, by your radio, do the walls close in to suffocate you? You ain't got no friends, and all the others, they hate you. Does the life you've been leading gotta go? Well, let me straighten you out. Get your shoes and socks on, people, because it's right around the corner.
Through the night and the whispering breeze, to the place where they keep your man, but never the seas. Out through the night and the whispering breeze, to the place where they keep your man, but never the seas.
Madrosas, and well they should. But us regular folks who might wear a tennis shoe or an occasional python boot know this extremely little inconvenience by the name of stink butt. How true that is. You know, my python boot was too tight. Couldn't get it off last night. A week went by and now it's July. I finally got that sucker off and my girlfriend cried. You got stink butt. Yo, stink butt, darling. Your stinking foot puts the hurts on my nose. Slippers, old puppy. What do you say? Bring the slippers right over here to Dada. Fido, I asked you to bring me the slippers.
Oh, Frank, I was so stoned I couldn't keep them in my mouth.
Fido, look here, boy. I know you're supposed to be man's best friend, boy, but I asked you to bring me the slippers, and you didn't bring me the slippers. And do you know, boy, that makes you liable for punishment to the full extent of Australian law?
Oh, really? Hurt me, hurt me, hurt me.
It'll be my pleasure, Fido. Just step right into my office. Constructed, it was a pretty sharp looking dog. It had hair evenly distributed all over its small, compact, canine type body. This hair, I will remind you, this hair was of even length. Then, all of a sudden, God made two very big mistakes. The first one was called man, and the second one was called woo-man. Woo-man looketh upon the unmodified poodle and saith unto herself, verily, under her breath, she saith, this dog could get me hot if it had a haircut. And so, the woo-man turned to the man and addressed him by his real name. She saith unto him, chump of chumps, go out and get yourself a job. And the man, verily being chump of chumps, got up off his booty and walked out of the cave and went into the world and got a job. Whereupon he dreweth a paycheck and came back with his precious, miserable, disgusting little paycheck back to the place where the woo man waited. And the woo man tooketh away the man's paycheck and with it proceeded to purchase a pair of scissors. And then, after buying the scissors, she attacked the dog. Now that's a very stupid idea with that thing over there. Why don't you put that out so you don't injure somebody? Safety first. Phew. It's almost like being at an Alice Cooper concert. Was saying, the woo man got these scissors, see, and she looketh upon the poodle, and she examineth the poodle, and she clippeth upon the poodle in the thorax, the medulla, the toowoomba, and the managua, leaving some area here on the legs, but cleaning off the feet so that the paws and the little claws would be more sanitary when exposed. And then she had the unmitigated audacity to put the aforementioned poodle into a quasi-erotic position, thusly, and I will demonstrate. She got that sucker sitting right in front of her just like that, and had him like this. And then she stuck her legs up in the air, reaching heavenward in a gesture of supplication, as it were, and saith these very words, which you might be allowed to cherish for the rest of your lives. start kicking them down just a little bit in the monitor system. It's getting up there too much. I have been informed that there are some members of the city council and members of parliament or whatever have come down here tonight to witness this concert in order to determine the future of rock music in your city. Now, let me say this, because we've been in this situation before. This is addressed. Quiet for a minute. This is serious. Bring the band on down behind me, boys. I don't want to waste your time with a lot of quasi-political stuff, but think about this for a minute. The problem is not whether or not to stop music in your city, but whether or not to open up a place indoors where it's not going to bother the people around here, and a place that's going to have good enough acoustics and enough seating so that you can have good concerts. And I think that if the people from the parliament and the city council are here, that they should think about that rather than worrying about the fact that there are some people who live in this area and in other areas around outdoor concert facilities who will complain no matter what kind of music or what kind of an event is going on there. Those people were born to complain, and they will always complain, and you'll never make them happy. And if you let them rule your lives, you're gonna be in trouble. So anyway, as far as you guys are concerned out there who are actually people who want to go to rock and roll concerts, I would suggest you don't forget about this, but if you have the right to vote, or if you have some way to apply pressure to the people who take care of your affairs here in this city, let them know that you want a place indoors that has good facilities for music, and maybe they ought to do it for you, since that's their job if they're the government. And the name of this song is Filthy Habits.
happiness in the world belong to me. Then our love was lost. You went away. Oh, now I shed my tears in lonely misery.
Don't go, girl, you better go away. life of you would be just not quite the thing for me. I mean, why is it so hard to see my way? Why should I be stuck with you? Just not what I want you to. Why is there any place to make me such a part of you? I did not know how to give it.
Thank you. Oh, and that's true. told me she loved me. I believe what she saw. Yeah, yeah.
head, Bobby was a friend of mine.
Open three of his eyes in the food stamp line, and open four of his eyes in the food stamp line, and open five of his eyes in the food stamp line, and open six of his eyes in the food stamp line. But Frank, you know, she might be a devil. Came in there, you know, with an extraordinary tan. Came in there with little horns on her head. She's asking, what's her name on there? Darkness. That's my enemy in the ocean. And had a little tail back here. Made the boy turn from anything to everything.
She wouldn't kiss him. He tried to ignore it, but it made him angry. He called her a slut, a pig, and a whore, a bitch, and a cunt, and she slammed the door in a petulant frenzy. She gives him some head.
And at the end of the story...
tragic true story of one of the little known heroes of the 20th century in the United States of America. Yes, you've guessed it, it's the true story of Michael Kenyon, professionally known as the Illinois Enema Bandit. This is his story. Bring the band on down behind me, boys. For the past 10 years in the Midwestern part of the U.S., out near Chicago, this guy, Michael Kenyon, a lonely, desperate sort of a man, has been ravaging the college-educated women in that area. What he did was, until they caught him, he went out at night with a ski mask on, carrying a briefcase. In the briefcase was a pistol, some rope, a thermometer, and an enema bag. He would break into the home of a college-educated woman and, at gunpoint, force her to submit to a cosmically oriented internal rinse job. The process went something like this. College-educated women can at times be forgetful of little things like locking the back door. And he'd always be able to spot the ones that were just on the fringe, you know what I mean? Michael would sneak up in through the back door, pull out his gun, tell the girl to lie down. Then he would have her naked and everything, and he would tie her up. Then he would remove the thermometer from his briefcase. And this is all true, by the way. He would take the thermometer out of the briefcase and... back in the briefcase. And then, when he had gained all the information that he needed to know about internal conditions, Michael would dash into the toilet with the enema bag and fill that sucker up with hot water. Then he would dash back into the main room and whoop, click, gurgle, 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 gurgle
and dash back into the yard. Well, no, he already did. Then, later that night, Michael Kenyon was arrested in Champaign, Illinois, earlier in 1975. He was tried, get that one. He was tried and convicted in December of 1975 and is now serving about 20 years on 5 counts of armed robbery because apparently there is no law against giving a college-educated woman a rinse job. However, because Michael got a little too ambitious, he was robbing the ugly ones, and that's what put him away. So, my advice to you here in this particular isolated part of the world is start your own trend tonight. And this is come on, play the bass, boy. Let's boogie, Roy. I mean, Michael.
Just might want a pump.
Hurt me, you are wrong.
you're under arrest. And the judge will have him for a special guest. The DA will order a secret test. And stuff his pudgy little thumbs in the side of his vest. Then they'll put out a call, you, for the jury folks, that's you. And the judge will say, no poo-poo jokes. They'll drag in the bandit for all to see, saying, don't nobody know, no, have no sympathy. Hot soapy water in the first degree. And the bandit might say,
why is everybody always
sitting on me? Well, did you call? It must be just what they all need.
Gushy, gushy.
It must
loose
be
booty.
Just what they all need. Help me, Doris. It must be just what. And now, direct from Burma.
This is all might offend you some. If it does, it's because you're dumb.
Let's have a little cheap, low-grade fantasy here tonight. Let's pretend that it was going to be a really big rock and roll show out of doors with nature and everything. Now, what do you need for one of these kind of shows in order to make it one complete thrilling extravaganza? The answer to the aforementioned question is simply this. You need audience participation. Now, we have come up with something that is so simple-minded, it represents literally the lowest ebb of audience participation. This is the most primitive form of audience participation. The only thing that is more primitive than this is sitting still. And I'm speaking of the motion of simply raising your hand and sticking your thumb up in the air and just going like that. Now, I don't know whether this is too much to grasp all at once, but try it like this. The hand comes up and then stick up the thumb. See, it doesn't hurt at all. Some of you are actually trying it because you think, well, maybe, I don't know. No, well, no, I'm too shy. No, I'm too evolved. It's against my religion. One thing or another, you're a member of parliament. You don't want to show us your thumb. You don't have a thumb. There are a number of reasons why people like you should not show your thumb to people like us. We don't care. We're going to go on with the rest of the song. But if you want to have a good time, just stick your thumb up in the air and let the wind get on it.
Show it!
Let me
see your thumb! Let me see your thumb!
Let me see your thumb! Let me see your thumb!
Let me see your thumb!
Let me see your thumb!
Let me see your thumb!
Let me see your thumb!
Let me see your thumb!
Let me see your thumb!
Let me see your thumb!
Let me see your thumb!
I'll never see you down.
Show me your thumb if you really dumb. Show me your thumb if you really dumb. Show me your thumb.
every night, pumping the gas every night.
Wind up working in a gas station. Wind up working in a gas station.
A man in the camel walks through by some wire. A man in the camel walks through by some wire. A man in the camel walks through by some wire. A man in the camel walks through by some wire.
Wow.
is all green and buzzing in his dungeon of despair. Prisoners grumble and piss their clothes and scratch their matted hair.
A tiny light from a window hole 100 yards away
is all they ever get to know about the regular life in the day.
And it stinks so bad, the stone's been choking,
weeping greenish drops
in the room where the giant fire above the works,
and the torture never stops. The torture never stops. The torture never stops. The torture never stops.
Slime and rot, rats and snot, and vomit on the floor.
And 50 ugly soldiers, man, holding spears by the iron door.
Knives and spikes and guns and the likes of every tool of pain.
And a sinister midget with a bucket and a mop where the blood goes down the drain.
And it stinks so bad, the stone's been choking,
weeping greenish drop
in the room where the giant fire puffer works.
And the torture never stops. The torture never stops. The torture never stops. The torture never stops.
Flies all green and buzzing in his dungeon of despair. An evil prince eats a steaming pig in a chamber right near there. He eats the snouts and the trotter's spurs, the loins and the groins is soon dispersed. His carving style is well rehearsed. He stands and shouts all men be cursed, all men be cursed, all men be cursed, all men be cursed. And disagree? Well, no one durst. He's the best, of course, of all the worst.
He's the best, of course, of all the worst.
Some wrong been done, he done it first.
Some wrong been done, he done it first.
And it stinks so bad, the stone's been choking,
weeping greenish drops
in the room where the Iron Maiden,
where the torture never stops. The torture never stops. The torture never stops.
It's me.
The torture never stops.
Are they sainted? since at first it was created. But a dungeon like a sin requires not but locking in of everything that's ever been. Look at her. Look at him.
That's what's the deal we're dealing in. That's what's the deal we're dealing in. That's what's the deal we're dealing in. That's what's the deal we're dealing in.
Thank you. Yeah! diamond. It'll finish our concern. I got everything in the world out here.
Andre Lewis on keyboards, Lil Skinny Terry Ted Pozio on Doris, Roy Estrada on bass. Thank you very much for coming to the concert. Hope you enjoyed it. And I hope the next time we come back here, we don't have to play in this stupid place. Good night.
Chin chin, said my, what sort of thing might this lady get high upon? The
$40 bill didn't matter no more when her sister got naked and laid on the floor. She said, Dynamo might win that bet, but she could use a little blow if I wasn't done yet. I told her, just because the sun wants a place in the sky, no reason to assume I wouldn't give her a try. So I pulled on her hair, got her legs up in the air, and asked her if she had any cooties in there.
Why don't you have cooties? Not cooties on there!
She was buns up feeling.
Buns up!
I was wheeling and dealing.
Wheeling and dealing.
She was running through the feeling.
She's having
a feeling. I started in the schooling. Dynamo watched from the edge of the bed with her lips just a twitching. Face gone red, some drool rolling down from the edge of her chin while she spied the condition her sister was in. She quivered and quaked and clutched at herself while her sister made a joke about her mental health. Still, Dynamo finally did give in, but I told her all she really needed was some discipline. So I said, kiss my aura. Aura? It's... how can I say this discreetly? It's real Angora.
Oh, yeah.
It's real Angora. Would you all like some more right here on the flora?
Yeah.
How about you, Juana? How about you, Doris? All right. Zircon-encrusted tweezers. Really? You like tweezers?
Tweezers.
If it wasn't so windy, I could sterilize them, but I won't be. I can't light a match and set my fingers on fire here in Preston. So I'm just going to have to use the tweezers on you without any kind of sterilization. I hope that this won't cause an infection.
Here it comes.
Couldn't say where she's coming from, but I just met a lady named Dynamo Hunt. She strolled on over and said, look here, mom, I got a $40 bill. Says, you can't make me come. You just can't do it. She made a bet for the sisters, a little bit dumb. She can prove it any time all men will scum. Of course they are. She called me a bum, but I knew right away she was really gonna. So I got down to it. I moved off her bloomers, stiffened my thumb, applied rotation to her sugar plum. I poked and I stroked some more. And you know what I heard? Little Dynamo again, little Dynamo.